you mentioned that you were that Andre the Giant's cast was large enough for you to play in. Is that one of the most wanted treasures that's on this program?
Oh, that's a great question. It is not one of this season's most wanted treasures.
Yes.
But, you know, it certainly could be. But I think I know where it is.
So what are the most wanted treasures that you and Triple H are going to start searching for that premieres this Sunday at 10 Eastern on A&E, Stephanie?
Absolutely. And there's a few different ones. And it's not just us, but it's also, you know, a cast of our superstars and legends. And, you know, it's really cool to hear their stories and their perception, you know, from these various moments, because you never realize sometimes how much a physical object can bring back a flood of emotions. And it's really that nostalgia factor. It's like owning a piece of history. It's kind of the reverse NFT, right? When you own this physical object, it's like owning that moment. So it, you know, we have Undertaker's gear when he debuted, which is, you know, really iconic in terms of, you know, the Undertaker character and everything that character came to mean. We have, speaking of Andre, we go looking for his passport as one of the objects. And I actually didn't expect even the thought of Andre's passport to make me emotional, but it did. It just brought me to tears thinking about this man and everything that he lived through as a giant. You know, he had acromeglia, which is a tumor on your pituitary, and he actually never stopped growing. But, you know, one of the reasons that we bonded so much is I've always, just growing up, you know, in the life that I've had, which has been remarkable, and I'm very grateful for everything. But I've always hated judgment. You know, people just judging other people for whatever reason. And it bothered me how some people would treat Andre like a freak, you know, like a sideshow freak. Some, not everybody, you know, a lot of people, he was revered and everything else. But I didn't like that. And I asked him one time, and I was a little girl, you know, I wasn't that old. And I asked him if it bothered him. And he just looked at me kind of quizzically and he said that it did. And it just really was the beginning of, you know, I mean, our friendship had started before that when I first met him. I was really little. My mom actually tells the story of he came to our house and we had a trampoline outside, and he walked over to the trampoline and put his hand out, and I stepped in his hand, and he brought me up to his cheek, and I kissed his cheek. I don't remember that, but my mom tells that story, and it's pretty cool. So, yeah, Andre and I go way back. But so his passport, you know, definitely brought back this flood of emotion for the man and everything he lived through, and the stories of the different territories. You know, he grew up on a very small farm in France, and went on to live this huge life. And that life is sort of captured in where he went in this passport. So that's one of the objects. Kane's original character, you know, before he made his debut in WWE, you know, that costuming and gear, which when you hear the story behind it, how the Undertaker actually discovered Kane, Glenn Jacobs, who is now the mayor of Knoxville County, you know, and you hear that backstory of how Undertaker was, you know, in Memphis, I think it was, and he was there doing a favor for a local promotion, whatever it was. And that's when he first met Kane. And then that launches the whole, you know, story of the Undertaker and Kane, and their whole backstory in WWE is that they were half brothers and, you know, all kinds of stuff. So there's just some really incredible artifacts and memorabilia that has so much meaning behind it. And hearing the stories from the mouths of the people who wore it or who were closest to it, it's just really, it's really fascinating, and it takes you on an unexpected ride.
Amazing. That is all amazing, Stephanie McMahon. I guess you're the original Princess Bride, essentially.
You know, one of my favorite movies of all time.
Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.